All right, you guys, welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a little while, but I want you guys to meet my newest addiction. We're going to be playing the TCG Card Shop Simulator, and I thought it'd be kind of fun to do like a 100% achievement playthrough type deal. So let's take a look at those achievements real quick. We've got some of the basic stuff. I mean, obviously, it's a basic card box. But then it goes down into some of the stuff that I haven't quite gotten into in the game yet. So 10 shop expansions, Destiny pack, 4 workers. But we get down here, collecting 2,500 different cards and shop level 100. So yeah, I think it'll be fun. Let's go ahead and hop into it. Yep. I've got probably 7 or 8 hours into the game, just messing around. Let's go ahead and, alright. We're calling it Nice Deck. Say that one fast, you'll get it. Alright, so we need to stock shelves. Let's see, we got $1,000 and 1 shelf. Can we buy a different shelf? Or another shelf? No, we cannot. That's nice. Alright, so I guess we're just gonna pick up... Actually, can we get... No, we need shop level 2. This is... gonna be the easiest way to get experience, I believe. But for now, we'll start with these. So, let me think here. We'll go 5. That'll be fine. Come out here, grab these, and let's stock the shelf real quick. I do have some mods enabled. Give me 1 second, and I'll pull those up for you guys. Alright, let's go ahead and open the shop real quick. There we go. We'll bring that in. Probably not going to need it just yet. The one thing we are going to need is some... Oh, we can't even do that yet. Okay, that's fine. Yep, that's all the boxes. Alright, got our first customer. Been a while since I've had to do this manually. Nope. That works. Come on. There we go. Okay, so the mods that I do have installed have nothing to do with pricing specifically. I have the mod to automatically set prices, so I don't have to check them every morning. I also have the bulk selling mod. We'll get into that a little bit later, but essentially you can set this so you always keep a card in your binder or your album. And then set the maximum amount. So if you have a bunch of cards under a dollar, then it will only sell the cards under a dollar. And you can set this for like 500 or whatever the case is. And then I have Hands Not Full. It allows you to hold more than just the 32 packs of cards. And that's about it. So to briefly explain the auto sell aspect of that mod, you're not necessarily making more money. you're just reducing the amount of work you have to do when it comes to restocking cards to sell them. It allows us to sell our more valuable cards while kind of getting rid of the less valuable duplicates. Let's buy a couple more boxes. Yeah, that'll work. All right. So you can get rid of your smaller duplicates. I'm aware of this. You get the workbench and it boxes up. It works essentially the same way as the mod, but it boxes up the lesser value cards and you sell them at like 100 in a box. But this way is just way easier. All right. $10. What time is it? Two left in there. Damn, we're gonna have to buy more cards here in a minute. All right, let's open our first cards. That is decent. Oh, I definitely forgot to buy that. Come on. Come here, stinky. We'll get that sorted out here in a little bit. Once we actually make enough to get the automatic sprayers, I'll just throw a couple of them by the door and we won't have to worry about that again. I believe they're $500 each, if I remember right. So we've got a little ways to go. Let's grab one more, complete this other quest. Nice. Play table. Here we go. I guess we'll go two for now. Not a huge fan of these tables, but put them back here. Set the price on them. Sure, that's fine. Oh, got our first achievement. Unlock the basic card box. Okay. That works. I mostly just wanted this, though. Get a bigger box of cards so we don't have to keep buying as many. Especially at this rate. Holy cow. It's starting to get dark. Let's turn the lights on. Alright, let's take a minute and open some more cards. Not bad. Getting all the new cards out of the way. There's a decent card. Over $10. There's a 16 nanomite. Not bad. 17 dollars, we're getting better. 32. All right. It's 6:50. The shop closes at 9. So pull the rest of these cards real quick. That's what, 5 packs? All right, we'll open them. All right, I'll stock the shelves with these. Let's wait for this guy to finish. There we go. Alright, 2190 out of that, so I need to have it round. It just makes this part of it way easier. Oh shit, what the hell am I thinking? Eight. Nope. I need the one with a 1 and a 0. Open this back up. Auto set prices. Run the card to the nearest dollar. Same with the items. There we go. That way we don't have to deal with the change. So if we hit a hotkey, automatically sets the prices up. Which, right now, not really a big deal. Later on, when you've got walls just full of stuff, it definitely saves some time. Especially when it comes to individual cards. Like when you go to sell these, it definitely helps. So we've got 3 of these for $2.99. We have like cheap ones. Okay, these Mufflins are 42 cents. So the way this mod works, let's say anything over a dollar. We close it, open this, hit the hotkey, and it sells. So we had 3 of these. Now we've only got 1. That's all it does. It just sells the extra cards for market value. Just a little quality of life thing. Instead of getting a shelf, putting each card on there and all that, this is just easier. Okay, it's 9 o'clock. We can go ahead and close the shop. Let's restock shelves. Need more of the booster packs. That is the wrong key. Like to get that one. We need like half a shop level before we can get that. I think we're gonna go ahead and buy these. One box should be fine for now. And then let's also get, oh, we need a box of these. So, all right, there's our restock for the night. Now let's move this just a little bit. I'm gonna bring it closer to this side. Give us more room over here. Move this. All right, and not quite enough money to buy another shelf, but we will get there. Just a matter of time. So that was the first day. We got everything established. These, what do I want to do with these? You know what? We're going to pick up... Here, this is how we're going to organize it. How do I want to do this? Here, let's just grab all these cards. Guess we could do cards on the left side, booster packs on the right. That would work, I think. Hang on to that box for a minute. Down. Nope. Throw these down here. So these only sell for $2, but they give you a lot of XP. Don't know why that is. Okay. Yeah, I have no idea why that is, but from my experience, it's probably one of the best ways to get XP. And XP is going to allow us to do more stuff, buy better card packs. Yeah, we've got a little ways to go. Dice are another good one. We're still a little ways off from that. And the figurines, I'm not a big fan of it. They don't really sell that well, at least from my experience. Even if you put them right at market price, they're still a little slow to sell. But you will have people leave bad reviews for not actually having them in stock, even though they don't buy them. It's absolutely weird. I guess it is what it is. The next thing we want to get, I really want to get a couple of these, so we're gonna need $1,000. And garbage can in the store is always nice. And then we can move on to actually expanding our shop. Oop, wrong one. This one. But this is what I want to unlock. So we gotta get to 15 and $5,000. That will at least get us a stock room. Opens this door right here. You can kind of see it through here. It's not a big room, but it's enough to put in a couple of the wire racks or warehouse shelves, so that we don't have to have boxes just laying on the floor like this. I guess this I can get rid of. Alright, let's open some more packs real quick. That'll work. See if we get anything worthwhile. A decent one there. Hey, there we go. That's huge. 1736 for that one card. That's pretty good. It's another achievement. What was it? Obtained a full art foil card. Nice. The only thing I wish you could do in this game, and if you can do it, I haven't found a mod for it, But from this screen right here, it'd be nice to be able to select a card to examine it. There's another full art. Not bad. It's not worth as much as that last one, but still pretty good. We need to try to get all the new cards we can. That way, we can get a little bit closer to that collecting 2,000 cards. It's a cool looking card, it's just not worth all that much. Alright, so let's see what we're sitting at for cards. So we're at 93 of 1332 for that album. And we're at 0 out of 1332 for that one, and obviously we don't have any ghost cards yet. But we'll get there, eventually. So that's a nice one. We've got three of these we could sell, because we should be getting a quest here pretty soon to sell cards. I think it comes after this task. We're letting 10 customers play in the shop, which we'll easily get done in the next episode. Which, if I'm not mistaken, we also have 100 customers. Let's see. We got 100 customers there. $1,500 there. They don't have like a 500 customer one? Okay. Let's see here. 5,000 customers. So whether we like it or not, we're going to have to run some tables. But that'll come with time. We got 8 on the first day. Can't really complain. I'm going to leave this off here. It's probably going to be about the average length of these videos. There isn't a whole lot to do until you get to the point where your shop is running itself and you can just sit back and open packs pretty much the entire day. But we'll get there probably by like shop level. Well, let's see. We can get there by shop level 15. We just gotta play our cards right. Get it? We gotta play our cards right and make sure we've actually got stuff that's selling. That way we can keep turning a profit to pay for our employees. I don't think that's going to be too hard.
Wow.
Got our store here. Nice deck. I did a little bit of rearranging. Not a whole lot. It is day 2. Let's go ahead and open the shop. Get these guys in here. I stocked some sleeves and just boxes. Just kind of rearrange stuff a little bit. Not much. So, let's see here. We got to get 2 more customers to play a game in the shop, which is fine. See where we're sitting at for achievements. Shop level 5, I think we could do in this episode. Maybe the rare card pack license. I'm not sure what that's going to take exactly. Collect 100 cards. We can definitely do that. And open 100 packs. Yeah, for sure. We've got that. So we're almost to level 5, actually. And then to get rare card pack. Yeah, shop level 5. So that works. There it is. All right, let's see here. We need to buy this for 300. So we just got to get to $300 and then we're good to go there. Let's see here. Go ahead and restock. Oh, we don't have any more of the actual booster packs. Okay. So maybe we should buy some booster packs. That's gonna cut into our profits just a little bit, but feel like it'd be worth it. So we got one guy sitting there. We just need someone to go sit with him. And then that task will be done. Oh, stop that. We're gonna need more of those. I probably should have saved that big box. That's right. I found it's always helpful to save one of these bigger boxes. Like, this box has nothing in it, but we're gonna save it, because if you need to move stuff between shelves, it makes life so much easier. Alright, so that's gonna be our 10 right there. We need more card sleeves. The 10 key does work for that checkout, but I don't know, I just never use it. It's just easier to use the mouse to me. Buy some more sleeves real quick. They're pretty cheap. What is it for our first renovation? All right, we got $300 for that, but I think I'd rather spend the $300 and unlock this, since we can't do it just yet. I don't really want to buy a card table and put it in the shop, but maybe we'll get around to it at the end of the day. What's that gonna run us? $400? Yeah, no, we'll get that other pack before we do that. Honestly, need more shelves. I mean, we don't have much to put on them, but wouldn't help. Or it wouldn't hurt. Could only help. That guy just sat down, he instantly loses. Wow. Rough day. Oh, we're gonna need more cards too. Alright, we're almost at 300. Oh, we got a stinky. More cards. Also get us one step closer to actually being able to get that achievement for opening the 100 packs, I think it was. We've got to be like partway there at least. Open some cards while we wait. That's a good card. I don't know if they'll just walk away after a certain amount of time standing at the counter, but I mean, I don't feel bad for them. I just don't want to miss out on the sale. There it is. Collected 100 cards. I thought there was one for opening packs, was there not? Yeah, open 100 card packs, okay. So we just got the 100 unique cards. Yeah, I'm not sure if having the light on all day actually helps or not. I tend to just turn it on at like 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock. That's a decent one. $300. Let's go ahead and get another achievement real quick. This one. Unlock the rare card pack license. Can't afford them yet, but we will. We'll get there. Just a matter of time. Alright, so there's 24 of those left. What are our bills right now? Alright, we're gonna have to wait on those. We need to get another shelf so we can stock more stuff. $200 for this shelf. All right, it's almost closing time. Made a little bit of our money back, but not much. Definitely gonna be in the negative at the end of this day. And we are out of cards. We're out of booster packs, pretty much. Okay. So I guess let's buy... What do I do here? Buy one of those. And I suppose one of these. All right, 9 o'clock. Grab these ones. Remember I told you to keep a big box? This is why. Now we can stock this shelf with these ones. All right, so we've got $147. When's our bills due? 7 days? All right, I can wait just a little bit. Let's, and we don't quite have enough to get that shelf it wants us to. You know what? Let's go with the rare card pack. We'll open these ones. Go with that many. See what we get. All right. Hey, there we go. A Budwing. 2077. Hey, that's even better. A full art. Don't know what that thing is. It's $61. That's pretty good. Another full art. $57. Getting too many new ones. We should be able to sell a bunch of these since we've got duplicates. Another full art, $57. There's a $22 EX. Okay, another EX, $21, and that is it. So we actually got some decent cards out of that last one. How many's in here left? 11? I think we'll save those for restocking. All right, let's do a quick sell. That's still a great card. All right, quick sell. $178 out of our duplicates that are below $8. So that's not too bad. So with that extra 200, I guess what we could do card table is 400. I think what we do is we just buy stock. So we're gonna need another box of the boosters. Probably another box of those. We'll see how much money we have afterwards. That's 140. Yeah, I think we buy another box of these. Maybe we'll open up some more of the gold ones. The rare ones. We'll just open the rest of these and we will probably end the episode there. So let's see what we get. Sharpen for 13. Not doing so good this round. All right, $22. I think this might be our last one. Yep. All right. So really didn't get a whole lot. We got to be getting close to the opening 100 packs, right? Okay. Well, let's at least get that one. What do we have here? What is this? All right, we're going to open till we hit that 100. There it is. That's a decent one. 15. There's an 18. Two in the same pack. All right. So we hit the 100. Yeah. So we hit the 100. We need more people to play in the shop. We gotta spray some more customers. Epic pack, sold a $200 card. make $1,000 profit in one day. Open 1,000 packs. That's gonna take a little bit. Same with the BO Buster. 500 cards. We've got to get somewhat close to that, right? A little less than halfway there. All right. Got a little bit of restocking to do, mostly with the card sleeves, some of the blue cards. But this is where we left off last time. We got a couple of achievements. I think we got the 100 cards, the rare pack license, and 100 card packs last time. Our next ones are going to be 100 customers played in the shop, clean 100 smelly customers, the epic card pack license, 4 shop expansions, $200 card. So it's going to be a whole lot of just kind of sitting around letting the game progress. So what I'm going to do is I'll just bring you guys back once we get some more achievements or something fancy happens, like getting a good card pull. Yeah, I'll bring you guys back then. All right, well, it's been a couple of days. I was just finally able to afford this. I also bought some of these furry board games, I guess. Systems Gate. Okay. Let's put some cards up for sale. We've got one of those, one of those. You know what? We can just do, All right, well, we're just going to do the two for now. All right, let's see what other ones we've got that we can put up for sale. I mean, I guess really nothing unless we open cards, right? So, you know what? Just to complete it, let's go ahead and open this. All right, it's an $11 one, but it's new, so we'll hang on to that. All right, let's see what we have now to sell. Is that it? That can't be it, right? There's one. Those two. All right. There we go. Now we got to sell cards to customers. So yeah, now we're just waiting. Oh my god. Okay, selling those cards for 50 cents. Yeah, we just need to sell one more card. And this task will be done. And I don't think there's another task for us to do. Unless that also came in the update that happened today. Not sure. Wasn't in the patch notes, at least. Alright. That last task, and it is done. There are no more, so that's good. We're at $500. Let's see what we can unlock. Well, we can get these boosters. What can we get in accessories at shop level 10? We can get some dice. All right, so I think what we go with is unlocking these boosters. And we can't even afford to buy them, but at least they're unlocked, right? Now we can afford to buy them. All right, It is the end of day 5. I've got a bunch of extra cards, so while I'm waiting for these guys to leave, we may as well open some more packs, because it's fun. Hey, there we go. $113. That's a good one. Take a break, check this guy out real quick, and we should be good to continue opening packs. We got one of those, and then a handful of these ones. Back to it. Not bad. $12 card. $11 card. All right. And that was it. So, let's see here. Where are we at inventory wise? We've got a little bit. Should buy another shelf and then move these three things to another shelf. That might be the play. Let's see, can I afford another shelf? Not quite. That's okay. We'll be able to in the next day. So I guess we continue. Alright, well, it is the end of day 6. Bought another shelf so we could stock some more stuff, moved everything around. And apparently, we got the 100 customers played in the shop. I didn't see it pop up, but apparently we've actually got that one. So I guess our next one will be probably unlock the epic card pack. I think I'm still 2 shop levels away from being able to do that. Yeah, shop level 12. So, well, shop level 12 and 800. That's going to take a little while. The other thing that would probably come next, maybe hire the one worker, or we could try selling a card. You know what? We could knock out, let's see. So that's sold, I can't talk. This one is sell a $200 card. What's the other one? Is there another one? Make $10,000 profit in a day, sell a $5,000 card. I'm surprised there isn't one that's like a $1,000 card. Just this $5,000, huh? I mean, we do have a, that's $1,000 profit in a day. Okay, maybe what I need to do is actually break down and possibly sell, where is it? This card. Then we can knock out 2 achievements with just that, providing I don't have to buy a bunch of stuff to restock. That would be the only caveat to that. So if I could get the shelves stocked in the day and then not have to buy supplies, then we might be able to get away with selling that and completing those 2. Let's end the day right now, because we don't have that much money, not enough to restock the way we need to. So our profit was, it's not good. When our supplies are at 830. All right. On to the next day. I think that is the plan, though. I think we, do the restock after one of these shifts and then call it good. Not have to restock again for the next day would be how we do that. I don't know. We'll see. And that guy just bought two of those four cards. I am somewhat tempted to either buy more tables or get rid of those two. That way these guys just come in and only buy stuff, but I don't know. We'll see. All right. Apparently we have cleaned 100 customers. There's no way we've actually done that. There's absolutely no way. Pretty sure this is the first box of this stuff that we've actually bought. And this is the first can that we've actually used. Might be a little bugged out there. But you know what? We'll take it regardless. All right. It is 9 o'clock. We're at $1,000. Just need to see if these guys are going to buy something before they leave. He is. Are you? No? Okay, bye. Yes. Yes. There we go. Oh, aw. You should have gone down there and got some of those furry board games. All right. It's going to be close. Not sure if we're actually going to break $1,000 profit or not. We should. I don't see why we wouldn't. I don't think I bought any supplies, which is why we're pretty much out of these now, but I don't think I bought any supplies, so we should be good. Let me restock the shelves real quick before we find out. I think that's all we can actually restock right now. Damn. All right, let's find out. Did we break 1,000 profit? We did. Nice. And I didn't even have to sell the good card. Well, our only good card. Sweet. All right. It is day 8.
Boring.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, wake up.
Yeah, I've got some money. We need to spend some money. So, in the last episode, we got the open 1,000 card packs. This episode, I kind of want to go for unlocking the Epic card license, which we just got to pay the fee, and that's that. Possibly 4 shop expansions, selling a $200 card, and maybe even hiring a worker. Yeah, I think that's going to be kind of the goal. Possibly collecting 500 cards as well. We'll see. So, first things first, let's, let's hire a, I don't know. Maybe we don't hire a worker just yet. Let's unlock, that's going to cost what, 1,100? Oof, that's expensive. That's like 1,800 to get all 4 shop expansions. But I think we can make that back. It shouldn't be too hard if we sell maybe this one for 200. Yeah, I think maybe that's what we do. So let's see, what's our cheapest one up here? Or I could just raise this one. This was a duplicate. Maybe we do that. Set this at 200 and see if it actually sells. It probably won't, but we'll see. I don't care if it doesn't sell. We've got more cards we can put up. So let's unlock for right now, because we're completely stocked up for the next day. We need 5,000 for this one. We're not even close to that yet. So let's get a... You know what? We can survive on $475. That'll be fine. Now we just gotta relocate stuff. Oh, you know what? Okay. Well, we're gonna have to wait until we reopen the shop to unlock the new cards. Now it's close enough. Okay, let's see here. We got our spray open. All this stuff should be fine. Open these. This is all stocked. These stocked. These are stocked up. Let's move this. We actually have room for one more table if we want to go that route. I don't really feel like going that route though. Set this against the wall. We got more room for activities. All right, cool. Let's go to the next day. All right, really expensive upgrades, but we did get the achievement. 4 shop expansions. We need to hire someone that costs 500. I think unlocking the card pack license is your 300 or 400. Let's see here. Oh, it's 800. Yeah, underestimated that one, but we should be able to make that money here pretty quick. Okay, we're going to unlock the next cards real quick. There's another achievement. Let's buy 2 of them. And we'll stock those here in a second. I still didn't get it. And then this guy just walked in. Come here. There we go. Still on our first box. I'm not sure why. Actually, we're still on the first can of the first box. It's weird. Okay. Let's, yeah, I think we... Oh my god, another stinky. We really need to get the automatic sprayers for the door. All right, let's throw some of these right here. Why are those only... Oh, okay. They're only going for 7. it's just a dollar more, but so be it. Oh, I was hoping he bought the $200 one. Or did the $200 one reset? It might have reset. I might have screwed that one up, you guys. Yeah, it reset. Damn. All right. Get these guys checked out. Okay, let's see. Which ones do we have that we could sell? Is there any that are close to 200? I guess that one, technically. Oof. I don't really want to sell it, but I do want to get that achievement. So we will do that. You bastard, don't you do it. Okay. All right, that one's set on 200. Line's getting a little long there. They had to have adjusted the customer rate because I don't think I've been this busy yet. Or maybe more customers come in the more you expand your shop. That's a possibility as well. Let's find out. Oh, one more. Sorry. Almost shortchanged them. Hey, you're not stinky this time. Nice. You're learning. $25 card. Buy the 200 one. There it is, $200. Got that one. Got another stinky. We got another stinky. Two stinkies, it's contagious. Another stinky. Damn. Kinda think we buy these too. Let's buy... No, I didn't want to buy that. Damn. All right. Well, misclicks are expensive. Ah, it's empty. All right. It's the first one we've used. Just blasting people in the face. That can't be good. All right. Okay, you're actually going to sit down and play. It is 9 o'clock. You know that, right? All right. They are gone. I think I'm going to buy a box of the purple cards. I've got purple boosters, but not actual cards. All right, let's see what we got here. Well, now we can just buy the big boxes since I accidentally unlocked those. And I think we can only afford one. That's fine. What are our bills looking like? It's not too awfully bad. Electricity is pretty expensive. That checks out. All right, we're going to open a whole box of these ones probably to end this episode. See if maybe we can get to the 500 cards collected. Yeah, we'll see what we get. And we're getting a lot of new cards. I'm just not sure if we'll be able to get that 100 that we need. I mean, if we keep going like this, we might. Hey, that's a good one. Like that. So, each card has 6 different versions of it. I don't know how many, like, that's the 3rd different one we've gotten of Ganon, which this company might want to be careful. Nintendo's a little sue happy for that one. All right. Getting some decent cards. That one looked way cooler than it was worth. Decent one. Hey, there it is. Collected 500 cards. Very nice. Take a look at that. So we sold the $200 card. I see this episode alone, we did 4 achievements. That's pretty good. Collected 500 cards. What's the next one? Hire one worker. Shop level 20. Legendary card pack license. I don't know what that's going to require shop level wise. We'll see after we finish opening these packs. Decent card. There we go. All done. So, let's see here. What's it gonna take to unlock the next ones? It's probably like shop level 20 if I had to guess. Yep, exactly. Shop level 20. We're at 17. It's not bad. Let's go ahead and buy a box of these. Just so that we can stock our shelves. I think what I want to do, let's see here. Let's pick up. We got 3 in there. Trying to make this as easy as possible because we're going to end up getting someone to stock these shelves in the next episode. And they have a rough time. Like, to put it nicely, they're a little special when it comes to stocking the shelves. If I have 2 boxes of the same thing, like, let's see. For instance, like these 2 boxes, if I have them stacked on top of each other, they'll take one, come over, restock the shelf, set it down right here, and then when they need to restock the shelf again, they'll come over, grab the other box, and then restock the shelf instead of using the one that's already there. So, that's a thing. Until we can get this unlocked, so we can put warehouse shelves in the back, this is our life right now. Yeah, I think we're good. There's 2 missing from there, but that'll be fine. Board games are all set up. These are just fine. All right, let's throw that away. We are good to go. I'm going to end this episode here. Let's check out our progress. All right, looking pretty good. I mean, minus this. We're operating in the red, but that's all right.
This is why we can't have nice things.
This episode, I would like to hire somebody. I did buy the next game, board games. Making a decent profit on it. I mean, cost us about $25, give or take. So that's a pretty good profit if they sell. I don't know if they'll sell or not. So I guess we'll have to find out. But a lot of this episode is just going to be exactly what you see here. Just doing checkouts, keeping stuff stocked. But I will bring you guys back once we actually get into progression, like hiring people. Maybe we'll make enough this episode to unlock this back room so we can actually store some stuff. So yeah. I'll see you guys here in a minute. All right. Well, we've made a little bit of money. Let's go ahead and hire Zachary Cole. Because, well, that's an achievement, and why not? Wouldn't hurt to have someone stocking the shelves while we're stuck doing this. Next big purchase is going to be these sprayers. The automatic ones. Put them by the door. We should be good to go. Probably going to need 2 of them so that they're actually effective. Do one like right there and then one over here and we should be all right. Where's this guy at? Is he just hanging out here? I think that's him down there coming to work in the blue shirt. All right, we'll wait for him to get here. Is he here? Hey, you. Yep. Restock the shelves. Well, I don't have any shelves with no labels on them, but I don't want you putting random stuff everywhere, so... No. This is exactly what I'm talking about. This guy just went outside to get that box, even though we have a box here that's already open, just to stock one on these shelves. Alright. Alright. It is 9 o'clock. Shop's finally closing. Our guy goes home right at 9 o'clock, so... Kind of useless. There is a mod to make it to where they stay until you flip the shop close sign, but... it is what it is. See, this is what I'm talking about. Why are all these boxes here? And I want to buy two of them. It's only going to leave us with $200, but we're all stocked up. I think we'll be just fine. We'll put one right there, and the other one can go like right there. So now as soon as they walk in, they're getting sprayed. Okay, that's almost a full can. That'll be fine. Let's fill this up. Alright, now we shouldn't have to worry about that, and we'll get the... Well, eventually, we will get the... Where is it? 500 smelly customers, just kind of passively. I think the next one we need to go for... Because once we hit shop 20, we can unlock the legendary card packs. And hopefully by then we'll have enough money to actually get the other shop. And we're passively working on customers playing in the shop and manually working on checking out 1,000 customers. I don't know how close we are to that, but yeah, it's going to be a little bit of a grind. So we may as well get the next day started. What is this? Oh, the purple cards. That's right. All right, let's get the next day started. Hey, we actually made profit. Kind of. Not much, but a little bit. So, take what we can get. Let's go ahead and get the shop open. Our guy should be coming to work any time now. You'd think he'd be here before the shop opens, but it is what it is. Go ahead, kick on the light. Do we have enough money to pay our bills? A few of them. So I guess we'll do that and that, and then almost enough for that one. What? Oh no, I forgot to turn these on. Damn. Alright, we gotta go spray this guy. Is that the only one that snuck in? Nope, this guy. Just standing there with that blank look on your face. Holy cow, this guy buy all of them? Damn. Oh, we got a stinky coming in. See if he gets sprayed. Double spray does the trick. Nice. Alright, the day is over. We made a little bit of money. Not great. But what I do want to do, since the new update just dropped, do we have playmats unlocked? Oof, those are expensive. I think we'll buy them. Unit price is $9.49, so they probably sell for about $15 if I had to guess. And then I think we're going to come up here... And we're going to buy the red dice. Just to kind of change it up a little bit. Cleared out two shelves right here. So we should be good there. I think we can only hold like 8. Yeah. Okay. That's fine. All right. And these are the mats. How many can we hold here? All 16. Noted. Got it. All right. So these sell for 17 a piece and these for 20. I was actually wrong on that. Okay. But apparently the new update that just came out like yesterday, I think it was, something like that, day before yesterday, maybe, is the people that come in and play will actually use the mats, but only the mats that you sell. So, I don't know. We'll see if it works. I know it was bugged a little bit where they intended it to be only the mats that you have unlocked will be used, but when they first released the update, and they've hotfixed it since, but when they first released the update, they were coming in with all the different mats. It looked really cool. So, all right, I think we're good to go. Let's go ahead and I can click the right button. Oh, all right. Kind of run low on duplicates. Need two more. That one. All right. We're getting down to the bottom of the barrel card value wise. Yeah, I guess just go ahead and end the day. All right, new day. New day, new items on the shelf, and we should, probably should have moved all these shelves down a little bit because we're going to need a new shelf here in a minute. That's right. We'll sort that out when it comes to it. Because we're pretty close to level 20 up here. And at level 20, we unlock the red packs, the legendary packs. As long as we've got $2,000, which I don't see it being an issue. I mean, I've got a bunch of extra cards I can just quick sell. Like, we're not going to be able to mark them up, but we at least sell them for market value, so think we'll be okay. Actually, if I get a quick lull in the action here, all right, let's open this up. Sort by price. Still got our good ones. All right, let's go ahead and hotkey that. $1,200. So we're at $2,000 now. So I think we'll be okay. Depends on how much stock I'm going to have to buy during the day. See, there we go. They're using the pads. Even though they haven't bought any, they're using them. So that's pretty cool. Man, I'm halfway tempted just to fire that guy. Like, if I got to come out here and do his job for him anyways, then... Yeah, you know what? You're terminated. Sorry, bud. Hey, there we go. Level 20. Nice. So now, sell that to him. We've got $3,000. Let's go ahead and unlock these ones. It's another one. And then, yeah, we'll buy two boxes of those. Why not? All right, let's pick up this mess. You know what? I'll do the organization after shop closes, but right now let's just buy another shelf. All right. Now we got those ones stocked. Go ahead and hotkey that. Those packs sell for $11 each. That's pretty good. Now, let's open a few of these. There are some decent cards in there. Hey, that's a good one. Alright. We are gonna... Well, I mean, the shop's already closed. Customers stopped coming at 9, so... Yeah, I think we're gonna go ahead and end this episode here. We got some empty boxes, so I can do some moving around. So... by the next episode, this will be all rearranged. I'll figure something out. I'll do the restock in between episodes, so let's do a quick recap. What did we unlock today? So we got shop level 20. We hired and fired someone, and then we got our legendary card pack license. So that's pretty good. What's the next one? Probably this one. All your base. Unlock shop lot B. Yeah, it's gonna be a little bit of a grind.
Move this man!
Alright, you guys. Well, it has been a few days, both in-game and in real life. Had some technical issues with OBS, so I do have to apologize for the quality of the last video. I wasn't aware it was like that until it was already done, but what you gonna do? So, since the last one, we passively got this. I don't know when, so I wasn't able to clip it, but we got the 500. I think the next one's 1,000, if there even is a next one. Yeah, I don't think there is. Just waiting on the 5,000 customers to play in the shop. I think I have a card that I could probably mark up to 5,000, but then we got 10,000 one to sell, so... we'll see. But today, I want to do... oh, we got the 1,500 customers that we're waiting on. That's fine. Today, I want to get this one and get everything organized. We'll unlock the Destiny Basic Pack. And there was one more. 20 shop expansions. Or was it 10? 10. 10 shop expansions. I went ahead and got the 8 one. Well, 8 of them, I should say. So, yeah, we got 8. It's 9 and 10. That's going to be another $4,000. So, yeah, we'll see how far we get. But right now, I'm kind of tired of boxes everywhere. So, we're going to open this up and we're going to buy some shelving. So let's go ahead and unlock that. There's the one achievement. And then let's buy some shelves. Want the large ones. We'll go with like 3 of these. Yeah, we'll do 3 and then we'll have to go another day. How do I want to do this? Let's turn this sideways. I guess we'll just put them against this back wall. There we go. Oh, that's space for what? Like 12 different items? The card packs we'll probably leave there. All right. Everything is cleaned up now. It's actually nice. Well, minus these, but... these are going to have to be rearranged now. So that's done. Let's see here. So we got the shop B. Let's go ahead and... can we afford to? Oh, I need to clear this. It's $3,000. Or we could spend $3,500 and just get the big box right off the bat. You know, I think that's the route we go. So there we got the Destiny Basic Pack license. And we'll buy one of those. Pretty sure I'm going to have to pay bills here pretty soon. Yeah, that's right. It can wait. All right. see what we can get out of here. All right, so a lot of new cards, some duplicates. It's all just fancy versions of these packs, but we do need another rack, or I can put some of these away. Let's see how much room we have in a box. Okay, I think we're good. So I'm going to run this for a couple of days, get some more money, and then, we'll expand the shop and get that achievement. All right, well, it's been a couple of days, couple of shop levels, and we've made a little bit of progress. I kind of rearranged this a little bit so it's easier to get to when I come through this door. We have some fancy cards. I'll put those up on the screen right now. Opened a bunch of packs, unlocked all of these, just kind of in general rearranged a few things. But yeah, let's take a look at our cards. So we do have one that I could probably get away with selling for the 5,000, I think it is, for the achievement. Got a few cards, nothing worth a lot that we have as a duplicate. However, I did pull duplicate ghost card of the Jack Turn. So, I mean, these aren't worth much. You'd think they would be, but they're really not. So that's a little disappointing. Go back to this. Let's see what we have for duplicates. Most expensive duplicates are right around $200. Then it drops down pretty quickly. I've got a lot between like 25 and 45-ish. But the reason I brought you guys back is so that we could do some unlocking. So one of the achievements, this one popped randomly during, I think it was the last day, a few hours in between recording sessions, but yeah, I think this was the last day. Let's see here. We've got 10 shop expansions, which we could do for about $4,000. That would leave us with $1,000, or we could get the next tier of cards, which I think is what I want to do. So let's go ahead and look at that. It is these ones. So 4,500. So we could do that, and then I could run it for a couple of days, and then we could come back and get the expansions, the shop expansions. Yeah, I think that's a game plan. There we go. There's that achievement. Let's buy 3 of these. Then we'll go ahead, stock the shelf, start the next day. All right. Those were all put up. What did they go for? $14? Okay. Well, we're going to have to do something about the shelves. We need to figure something else out. Somewhere to put all these board games. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and run this for a couple of days. And then I will bring you guys back here when we have enough money to finish our 10 shop expansions, which will be that spot there and that spot there, I believe. All right. Well, it's only been one shift, but we've got enough money to do the shop expansion. So we're going to go ahead and do that right now. So let's see, in here we need 9 and 10. Yeah, we should have enough. There we go, 10 shop expansions. We also have enough for, want to pick up another shelf for the back, and I also want to pick up another play table. Yeah, I think that'll be fine. This is the shelf. Oops, wrong button. There we go. And we'll grab this other play table and slap it down. Actually, we might be able to do two. Possibly. I just gotta get this lined up just right. Alright, let's move all these ones. Oh yeah, plenty of room for another one. Wrong button. Let's go ahead and buy another one. There we go. Now this needs to move a little bit. You know what? It'll be fine right where it's at. I'm not worried about it. Okay. So the reason I bought the two new tables is because... So we just hit the 1,500 players or customers played in the shop. However, there's one for, I think it's 5,000. Yeah, 5,000. And that's it. So once we hit 5,000, we're good. But right now, I mean, we just hit 1,500. We might have had like 30 people today. So it's going to be a little bit of a grind. I think that more tables means more players, hopefully. The downside to that is with the... Well, one of the more recent updates is once players are done, there's an increased chance that they'll come over and buy a card. So eventually might need another one of these or a bigger one. Do they have one that's got more than 10 slots? Because that's one we have. That's 400. That one's 10 slots. This one's 12 slots. It's $2,000 though. Oof. Yeah, I don't know if I really want to spend $2,000 on a table when I can just get another one of these and put it in there. So maybe we don't do that, but all this miscellaneous stuff seems to be selling pretty good. Like these deck boxes, the dice, the play mats. I actually sold a couple of these. These ones really suck for selling. I'm still on, I think, my first box of them. Yeah, I'm still on my first box. We've got 9 of those left. So, I'm not sure if maybe the balancing is off in the game. But, like, these puzzles sell out no problem. These ones, kind of hit and miss. These ones hardly ever sell. And I'm not sure why. I don't know. Maybe it's something that needs to be rebalanced. But... yeah, I'm going to do a little bit more organizing between episodes and run it a few more days so we got money to do some other stuff. Let's see what our next ones are. Sell a $5,000 card we could probably do. 10,000 profit in a day, we could probably do that if we were to also do the $5,000 card. Because right now we're hovering right around $4,000 to $5,000 a day. So... let's see, just to recap this episode, we did the major shop expansion. We unlocked the Destiny Rare Pack. We got 1,500 customers to play in the shop. We did the Destiny Basic Pack. And I believe we did all your base, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe BO Buster 2. I'm not sure. I really don't remember. I don't think that. I think we did... all your base, the Destiny pack, popular card shop, Destiny rare pack, and major shop expansion. So, yeah, we're going to be looking at a lot of money to get the last expansions for the shop. Yeah, that gets expensive pretty quick. Yeah, it's going to be quite a bit. And then we have the back room that we can also upgrade. It's not as pricey, but it's still... kind of pricey. The biggest thing is shop levels. So we're going to have to open a lot more decks. As you can see in the right-hand side of the screen, I've opened over 5,000 decks. Our next milestone is 10,000 decks. So I'll probably work on that in between episodes as well. Got some lofty goals. If you look at the right, we're about 120 packs. Well, 116 packs away from 10,000 opened, and I've done some rearranging. I've got all of our most valuable cards out here. I am also going to open up the phone. I should probably pay some bills, huh? That's expensive. Alright, well, you know what? The rest of it can wait. I think what I want to do is go ahead and hire these three people. So we can get that achievement. And then when they get here, if they're going to get here, well, whenever they get here, we'll set them to stocking shelves since we have pretty much everything already in stock and then some. Where are they at? Where's he at? Is this one of them? He looks, yep. Okay. Restock shelf. And you, welcome back. Go restock shelves. And there should be one more. Is it this one? Yeah, okay. Go restock shelves. And they're already falling behind. Why are you walking around to the back? Kind of the goals for this episode anyways. So I want to... We just got the tight-knit team. I would like to get the... Possibly the Destiny Epic Pack, which is the next one to unlock. Make 10,000 profit in one day. I think I kind of already screwed that up by paying the bills. We might be able to get 20 shop expansions. Probably not going to get the $5,000 card unless I pull one out that I don't really want to sell. I think I've got one that's fairly expensive. Yeah, this one I could probably get 5,000 out of. I think I'm going to wait on that because we're also really close to collecting the 1,500 cards. Is it 15? Yeah, 1,500 I believe is one of the cutoffs for it, isn't it? Or is it 2,500? Yeah, 1,500. Okay. And then we also got this upgraded. This one's way nicer. It's just one thing right there instead of the other two. Let's go ahead and refill that. I don't know if the people I have stocking shelves will refill that as well, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. So yeah, I'm just going to let the day play through. I'll bring you guys back at the end where hopefully we're going to make some money. Okay, that was the end of the day. We sold a lot of cards. I didn't buy anything for restock, so that shouldn't keep us down other than I might have messed it up in the very beginning when I went ahead and paid one of the bills. So let's go ahead and end the day and find out if we made it. Nope, that was 5,000 profit because I paid that bill. Okay. Well, I guess we're going to run another day and see what happens. All right. Is the end of another day. There goes the last customer. Let's check this. All right, that needs refilled. So we have money. Not a lot of money, but we have money. We got 24,000. Ugh. I don't know what we can do with this. Kind of. Okay, so let me back up here for a second. So I fired this guy and this guy because they were slow as hell. I kept this guy just to kind of keep up with stocking shelves. And then this guy's just good at doing the checkout. So we're going to keep those ones. How are bills looking? Expensive. Like, really expensive. Okay, we still got 2 days on that, though. And we did sell the $1,000 duplicate card that I had up here. Now this is all, like, the cheaper stuff. So hopefully we cross that 10,000 threshold. We'll see. Hey, there it is. All right. So I'll run it one more day, and then we will open packs. All right, it is the end of this day, and I hold in my hand pack 10,000. So let's go ahead and open it. There we go. 10,000 packs. It's been a lot of AFK and letting it kind of auto open with this mod, fast pack opening. Disabled it so you guys could actually see it. Because if not, then it's this speed. So that's kind of an issue sometimes. All right. I've got a lot of restocking to do. One thing I did want to see about doing. Let's see here. What do we have left? 20 shop expansions. I think I've got like 6 left. And I think it's still locked by level as well. We've got to be getting at least halfway to 5,000 customers played in the shop. I'm not going to add any more tables to the shop just yet. I think that's about it for now. It's going to be a lot of grinding off camera just to get the probably the money for this, reaching shop level 50. I think level 50 is when we unlock the legendary packs as well. Let me double check that, make sure I'm not lying to you. Let's see here. There's the rare, there's the epic. That's at level 40. So yeah, level 50 is when we can unlock these. We can already unlock these ones, but that's 5 grand. Maybe we don't do that just yet. Let's look at shop spaces. We can unlock 4 more. In fact, I'm pretty sure we even have the money to. But these ones are gonna take a little while. Gotta get up to shop level 47, so that's gonna be more off-camera grinding just to get to that. I don't know, maybe I'll fire up a stream and just sit here and grind it out on stream one of these days. If I ever get some free time, that is. But in the meantime, let's go ahead and unlock these. Leaves us with like 3,000 left. That should be enough to restock our shelves back here. Yay, now I get to reorganize and probably add more tables if I'm being honest. Yeah, it's probably room for another table or two. Buy one and see if maybe we've got enough room after this one. I don't think we're going to. Ooh, if so, it's going to be very close. In the name of science, right? Oh, it is so close. Alright, well, we're not going to be able to do that, so we'll box it up and sell it. That's alright. I kind of want to save up some money. I keep opening the wrong one. I want to save up some money and get some of these. They have more space, so I could do 12 of each item, or I believe it's for the bigger stuff, like it holds 12 items, but I can hold up to 64 of each. So that's like 2 of these shelves combined. And if I do one row down this way, like, yeah, do one row like right here, and then one row like right here, I think we could get rid of all of these shelves and these ones in favor of those. I do kind of like these ones for like just the random stuff, so I'll probably keep those. I might think about upgrading to the bigger displays, possibly. I don't know. It's been a couple of days, couple of levels. I've done a little bit of expanding, kind of bought some different types of inventory. And yeah, figure I'd bring you guys back for this episode. We'll start it off by expanding that and then unlocking some more cards. So let's start with the final expansion. $6,000. There's the achievement. And yeah, now our shop is maxed out. Now we do still have a lot in shop B to get. We've got 4 more to get, but those are all level locked. So we're going to hold off on that. In the meantime, we are going to come down here and unlock... where is it? These ones. Yeah, I think we do that. Go ahead and get that going. Buy like 4 packs of those. Go ahead and get this stocked up. Okay. Got everything shifted down by 1. We're gonna have some empty shelves for now. It's probably not the best idea. I mean, yeah. We're gonna have some empty shelves for now, but that's okay. Go ahead and grab this. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and run this for a couple more days. Oh, by the way, I do have, let me see if I can pull it up. 3 or 4 people, 1, 2, 3, 4 people working for me right now. I just put Clark Cash and Lauren Posey on the cash registers. And then the other two just stock shelves while I sit here and open packs all day. So... yeah, it's a fairly decent system I have set up. Probably going to unlock some more of these figurines. We're kind of limited on how much we actually have left to unlock. Like, figurines are kind of about it. Still waiting for, well, I guess figurines and then the playmats. There's a lot of playmats. So that might help fill the shop a little bit. Still waiting on the next comic book. These things actually sell pretty decent. And then, obviously, we're still waiting on, like, these as well. So I might go ahead and buy these in between episodes, or in between days. Probably go ahead and buy these as well. I mean, why not? Yeah, I don't want to wait the 8 levels till I unlock this, so I'll go ahead and get these. But, yeah. That's kind of where we're at right now, so a lot more grinding to do. Do have a few more ghost cards. Let me see if I can push the right button and open it up. No duplicates. I'll show you the duplicates here in a minute. Sort by price, why not? So, we've got a decent amount. Almost 3 pages. So, that's not too bad. I've been putting all the duplicates in here, which we've only gotten 3 so far. So, there's that. But, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and run this. I'll get these shelves filled up a little bit more and bring you guys back once we get close to getting something else. I don't know how close we are to the 5,000 people played in the shop yet. Which is, right here. The card shop. Once we hit the 5,000 customers played in the shop, then we can go ahead and get rid of those desks. That'll give us more room for, I don't know, other stuff, I guess. Shop level 50 is probably going to be our next achievement if I don't decide to go ahead and just knock out the higher 8 workers, which I probably will do in this episode. This episode's probably going to take 2 or 3 days of playing to record because I'm kind of limited on time to play. I'll keep opening packs and maybe we'll get the foil ghost card. I doubt it until we at least get the Destiny Legendary pack unlocked, but hopefully we'll see. So I'm going to go ahead and run this and I'll see you guys back here in a few days. Okay, you guys. Well, it's been 4 days in-game, like 2 in real life, 1, 2, 2, I think. I don't know. It's been a little bit, but we just hit shop level 50. So with shop level 50 comes new stuff we can buy. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Oh, and I think it also unlocked this one, but we're going to go ahead and buy these ones. So there's that. Let's see. Okay, so it's been 2 days. So we need to get 5,000 customers to play in the shop. We need to hire 8 workers, which I don't know if we actually have the funds to do just yet. Sell a $10,000 card, which I don't think we have anything that's close to that. I'll check here in a minute. Shop level 100 and collecting 2,500 cards. Okay. Well, let's take a look at our deck. Price. There we go. Okay, so we've only got a couple, like, might be able to get away with selling them for like $5,000, but we're gonna need to do better than that. That's the wrong button still. These guys keep sneaking by and I don't know why. Pretty sure it's just... Okay, what's going on here? Oh, it's not on. I was playing around, like, I bought the bigger one and it just... I wasn't a big fan of it. So... It holds three more of these canisters, and it does work, but I feel like the recharge, like before it can spray again, was quite a bit lower, or slower, I should say. It might be about the same speed, but I think I might have to get another one. It'll be nice once we get the 5,000 customers that play in the shop done, so that I can kind of rearrange everything. Maybe just put a few desks over here, or a few tables over here, and then move the cash register over here. Maybe rearrange the way the shop is laid out, but yeah, I don't know. And see, when that happens, two of them come through at the same time, only one of them gets sprayed. So I need to, came right to me, you get sprayed in the face. Nice. I need to get another one to put somewhere, but then the question is, where do I put the other cash register? I mean, I guess technically I could put it over here and just move that over there. That way I've got room to put another one of those right there. Okay, where'd she go now? Okay, she's going back to work. Now we can buy another one of these for the sake of saving space. I think we put it right here. But then we still might run into the issue of if two come through and both of these go off. I don't know. I'll have to keep an eye on it. The only reason I bought these card sleeves is I had a bunch of customers complaining that I didn't have them. So I figured I may as well do it. But all I had to do was add another shelf in here. Wasn't too big of a deal. We're almost out of cards. That's fine. Are people even using this register? Yeah, okay, that'll work. I mean, it's a little tight getting through here, but it'll be just fine for now. Yeah. Let's take a look and see about these other ones. So that's going to be $10,000, $5,000. So we need like $16,500. To hire these guys. Okay. I'll bring you guys back at the end of the day and we'll see if we got the money to do that. Okay, you guys. The shop has officially closed for the night. I got a bunch of restocking to do, but I'm not too concerned about that. Let's go ahead and get the recruits. We do have the money for it now. There we go. There's another one. Good old top recruiter. What's the next one? $5,000 card we could probably do. Customers played in the shop. 30,000 profit. $10,000 card, shop 100. I mean, a lot of this is just going to be time. Card connoisseur. I mean, that one we can kind of start on. I mean, we do have like $4,000 left still. Let's see here. So I think majority of our cards that we have left to collect are going to come from these ones. Like the Destiny packs, because I've opened a fair amount of these ones and these ones, but I haven't even touched these ones yet. So maybe we buy like, I don't know, four of each. And then we just start opening packs. Okay. Opened 8 boxes. Yep. As expected, we got a lot of new cards, but not so much value. Our most valuable duplicate, 771. Oh, I did get a new ghost card off camera. Let me see if I can find it. This one. Oh, it's pretty cool. I like the artwork on it. All right. Well, I need to sit down and figure out where we're missing cards and where we aren't. So give me like 5 to 10 minutes. I'll be right back. All right, you guys. Well, I have done the math. It really didn't take 5 to 10 minutes. Yeah, did the math. We need 541 cards somewhere. So yeah, I think it's just going to come down to just opening packs. A lot of packs. So let me just sit here and open packs for quite a while. I'll bring you guys back if I find anything good. Holy cow, you guys. I actually did it. It is currently like 3:15 in the morning for me. And I've just been sitting here grinding hard packs, trying to get the 2,500 collected. And yeah, I just pulled a holo ghost card worth 11,000, almost 11,000. I'll give myself the credit. It's 11,000. So that should pop the achievement. There it is. Go ahead and stop this real quick. Wow. There it is. And still going back to the 2,500. We are currently sitting at about 159 short of 2,500. Well, 158 at least now. Plus probably a couple I've already opened. I don't know. This round of pack openings, I've already gone through about 170 cards, give or take, or 170 packs, give or take. So yeah, that was a massive find. And if nothing else, then that'll, we can sell that one and at least get this one knocked out too. Now the 30,000 profit in a day, because I am using the mod, this bulk selling, oh, that biller, the bill amount adjuster is for the girlfriend, because she doesn't like paying high electricity bills. So, but yeah, this bulk selling mod right here, I'm selling everything under $200 in value, and it doesn't really benefit me at all, other than cuts out the middleman of actually having to put it on the display to have it sell. And it just helps me better keep track of all the card numbers over here, the collection numbers, because I can actually sell them, so I'm not having to count all the duplicates, because this number includes duplicates. So this actually helps quite a bit, just being able to sell most of them, so it's just less I have to count. And subtract it from 2,500, and well, add it to 2,500, then subtract these numbers from it. And yeah, it's a whole process. But yeah, just thought I'd bring you guys back when I pulled that. And I guess we keep going, because we need to get to 2,500. Okay, you guys, I don't know what the opposite of when it rains, it pours is, but this would be it. This one's worth about $6,000 more than the last one. And we're still grinding packs. So, yeah, I don't know where this is going to go from here, but it's looking good. Okay, so it's been about 20,000 packs since we pulled our last full art foil ghost card. I'm gonna end this episode here. We're about 51 short. We have $241,000. We have a lot of duplicates. These are all super expensive cards. And these are all the duplicate ghost cards we have. Yeah. Let's just kind of go over the achievements. Let's see here. We got the full shop expansion. The Destiny Epic packs were unlocked. We hit level 50. We unlocked the Destiny Legendary pack. We hired 8 workers, and we are the proud owners of the Lucky Bastard achievement. So I'm going to leave this off here. I'm going to keep opening packs off camera, but I'm going to try to get the last card that we need for the 2500 on camera so we can kind of start the next episode with that. But yeah, we've got a few left to do. Probably not too difficult besides maybe grinding to shop level 100. All right, you guys, we are back in Card Simulator here at the nice deck, and So you probably noticed my money. You probably also noticed the 84,000 packs I've opened on the right-hand side of the screen. Well, that's because I was pushing for the 2,500 cards. Pull this up. For this one right here, collecting 2,500 cards. And as of right now, we are 15 short. That was until today's update. So I don't know whether to be happy about the update or to be a little irritated about it. I have sunk so much time into just sitting here and grinding through pack openings. But so today's update, we skip towards the end, there was only 111 pages of cards. Today's update added more cards. So that 15 that we need could come pretty quick. They've added more cards for the regular Tetramon. I don't know if they've added any for the Destiny. I haven't looked. It does kind of look that way. I haven't checked. Honestly, I saw that and I wasn't very motivated to keep grinding packs off camera. Alright, so yeah, it looks like they added extra ones for there too. Let's check Ghost. I don't remember how many Ghost had. But we did get a few more of the full art foil Ghost cards. I think that's one that we already had, possibly. So we got that one, and that one, and that one. I think that... Oh, no. We also got the Jack Turn one, too. So, yeah, it doesn't look like they added more for the ghosts, at least at first glance. I'd have to go back and look at the recording and figure out how many there were. We do have a bunch of duplicates and a bunch more duplicates over here. Like, a lot of these are worth quite a bit. So, yeah, I figured we'll just go ahead and open a few more packs with you guys here on camera. We'll get like 3 boxes, why not? There's 2 new ones. So yeah, they definitely added more. These ones are kind of cool looking. There's another one. And there it is. So it took us 84,766 packs being opened to actually get 2,500 cards collected. It probably would have been another, like, probably, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5,000 more packs if it wasn't for the new update. But yeah, with the new update, I'm really surprised they didn't add more achievements. since they did add the ability to trade cards with customers, I feel like adding more achievements would have been kind of interesting. They could have done a few of, you know, make so many trades with customers, or even something along the lines of trade a customer for a, you know, a card of this value. But let's throw a couple of these out. I don't remember how many I pulled. Okay, so if nothing else, we should be able to make 30,000 with just the cards that we have out if they all sell. Now that's a big ask, but we do have everything maxed out. I did upgrade the rest of this area with the money that I made. So they didn't add anything new here. I honestly, this is the first time technically the second time I've opened the game since the update. Let's see, did they add anything else in here? No. Accessories, did they add anything? Doesn't really look like it. These might be new. I don't think that one is, but this one might be. I don't remember that. Figurines, anything new here? We pretty much have almost everything unlocked. We've got that one and that one left to unlock. Let's see about furniture. Did they add any new furniture? Does not look like it. Okay, well, let's close this, open the shop, and see if it's going to give us credit for the $30,000 in a day. No, we are still in the negative, so it didn't count any of that money. You know what? I'm okay with that. That makes sense. So, I guess we just open the shop and let our workers do their thing. Alright, so it doesn't look like our $10,000 card sold. I mean, I guess I could technically lower this price to $10,000. We'll give it one more day, maybe two. And if it doesn't sell, then consider lowering it. Alright. Now he should go home. Oh, go home. Alright, fine. Let's just end the day. $86,000 profit. So there's that achievement for capitalism. So we basically have to sell a $10,000 card and reach shop level 100. All right. I think the 5,000 customers, I wish there was a way to track how many have played in the shop, but I don't really think there is. There it is. So it must have been that guy, I think. All right, sweet. I think I'm done buying stuff for the shop. I'm just gonna sit here and kind of let it play through until I get, I don't know, at least close to shop level 100, or until I can actually get to the 5,000 people played in the shop. So I guess I'll bring you guys back once I get to that point. So I think I'm causing absolute chaos now. I've sold my stands in here, put an air freshener deal there, and some more tables. But I also added this table. Now they're trapped forever. I don't know if they'll stay after I end the day or not. But if I had to guess, I'd say probably not. I don't know. We'll find out. They're free to leave. They aren't. Okay. Well, I guess we're going to end the day. See what happens. Another good day of profit. They probably don't stay. Oh, okay. Yeah, they don't stay. You know what? We'll leave that there. Let's move this, I don't know, somewhere else. Where can I even move this? I guess right here. be really the only place I can move it if I can keep it from snapping into stuff. Whoops. Should probably open the shop first, huh? There we go. Set that right there. That's fine. Those are refilled, and I'm pretty sure this is refilled. All right. Well, we keep going. All right. Well, it has been a couple of days, and to answer my previous question, there is a way to figure out how many people have played in the shop. You just have to come here to your game event app on your little phone. Go all the way to the end. So just that day alone, we got about 90 people that played in the shop. So we've got a little ways to go yet. Okay, you guys. Well, it has been about a week of just playing off and on, trying to get everything finished up for this series, I guess. And we're close. We're really close. We are at level 99, just turned level 99, and almost 5,000 people played in the shop. Those are the last two we have to do. If I can pull this up. Should have done this beforehand. So yeah, 5,000 customers, drop level 100, and we'll be done with all 40 achievements. So, as you can see on the right-hand side, let me try to angle that so it's easier to read. There you go. 133,000, almost 200x open. I haven't been selling cards. I've just been selling the packs for XP and then kicking people off these tables. That's about it. I've got the table set to $2 an hour. It was $1 an hour. Figure I may as well up it to $2. It's fine. And yeah, actually, while I'm explaining stuff, may as well go ahead and start the next day real quick. So if you just let people come in, play as long as they want, and then leave, you get about, with five tables, six tables, probably like 60 to 70 people, maybe, if you're lucky. But if you kick them off as soon as they start playing, 126 a day. So let's go to day 79, and I will show you what I am talking about. Yeah, okay. Those are refilled. So we just gotta wait for people to come in, and then you can just kick them off. And most of the time, if there's someone walking up to the table, as you kick people off of it, then just like that, they automatically sit down, start another game. I've had it happen up to 3 times at the exact same table. Like, this guy's going to sit down, kick him off, that guy sits down. I've had it sometimes. Okay, that guy's going to go. Oh, are we going to get a third? We just needed one person right there. And he's going to walk all the way around. Nope. Okay. And these guys, I don't know if they add to the total amount of customers in the shop. I'm assuming they do. And at max level, I believe it's like 28 customers you can have in the shop at one time. And that's dependent on the size of your shop and your shop level. So, and these I just decline unless it's a new card they're offering. There's a lot of people that are complaining that I don't have such and such for sale. Yeah, I just don't care. I'm just trying to get this over. You, stop. But yeah, I'm only making about, I don't know, anywhere from like 20 cents to 50 cents per game. But most of my money is coming from all those packs that I open, just constantly refilling this. I guess if I wanted to be more efficient, I'd get rid of some of these shelves and just do a couple more of these, but not overly concerned about it. Usually by the time I fill up all these slots and kick these people out, don't care. No, don't want it. Kick those guys. Not a whole lot of XP and people playing in the shop, but hopefully we get there. So I am gonna bring you guys back here in just a couple minutes. We are close. We only need about 24 more people to play. And now it's starting to get a little bit busier, so this is kind of promising. I think that's 20 now we need. These will be the last ones. There it is. Oof. All right. So 5,000 customers played in the shop. Now we just have to hit shop level 100. So I don't really care what happens in the shop now. I mean, we've got plenty of stuff to stock. These are all just card sleeves because why not? Make sure these are refilled. All right. We're good. But we're going to go into here. We're going to buy as many of these as we can. Actually, you know what? Before we do that, let me save the game in case it crashes. Okay, now we're going to buy as many as we can. Or maybe just 150. Delivery three is $300. I think that's reasonable for 150 boxes. Now hopefully this doesn't crash the game. If you look down here in the bottom corner, I'm at 75 FPS. I've got it locked, so oh yeah. All the way down to 6, 5. Can we go lower than 5? No? I mean, they're still spawning in, so there's still hope. There's 4. Oh, this is atrocious. There's 3. 3 FPS is what we ended up with. So, yeah. I'm just gonna sit here and open packs, and I'll bring you guys back when we get closer to level 100. All right, you guys, we are almost there. It's been quite a few boxes. Quite a few boxes. There's still quite a few that I haven't opened yet, but that's right. Just a few more packs and we should be done. And then I'm going to take a decent sized break from this game because it's kind of all consuming at this point, just trying to get it done. And I would like to play some other stuff, put it on the channel a little bit quicker than what this one's doing. There it is, level 100. Go ahead and stop that. And we are 100% complete. I think I'm gonna maybe not play this game for a little while. If there's a big content update or something along those lines, then yeah, I'll hop back into it. I'll have to clean up this mess, but that's all right. So I'm going to leave this off here. We 100%ed the entire game. All achievements. Shop level 100. 5,000 people's played. All kinds of packs opened. Cards collected. I guess I could do this real quick. So, well, about 99 short of collecting all these ones. For the ghosts, we are, can't do math, but I think that's 29. And then, number. Yeah, we're about 140 shy on these. somehow still don't have that one pig right there, but that's okay. I think we are calling it there. So if you guys enjoyed it, go ahead, leave a like. Subscribe if you guys haven't yet. Let me know down in the comments if there's another game you want to see 100%. I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you.